everybody. It's Laz. All right. I've been asked questions through email, through many different formats, that because DHCP Relay Agent is part of your new CCNA. DHCP Relay Agent really has been around for a while in Microsoft and in Cisco, but now they're getting a little bit more whatever. Remember, a DHCP server has a process. It's called DORA. Discover, offer, request, and acknowledge. The discover part is a broadcast. Routers do not like broadcasts. Why? Because broadcast is yelling. So a router says, oh, you're yelling at me. I'm not going to pay attention to you. I'm going to drop that packet. So discovers don't go beyond your local segment. So what does that mean? That means that these poor individuals over here are not going to get an IP address. All right, they're not going to get an IP address. So what is it that we're doing? I set up two routers, or we're going to set up two routers, okay, with proper IPs, SATA 30. Now, everybody, I've experienced trauma where I'm teaching a networking class, not necessarily specifically CCNA, but a networking class, and they're asking me, why are we learning IP addressing? If you don't know how to IP address, you're not going to create a network, okay, regardless. So, and don't make the excuse, well, it's not my job, somebody else does that. Well, then you don't need to be in IT, all right? IP addressing is the fundamentals of networking. You need to know that. So we're using up here between these two interfaces, we're using the 10.1.1.0 SATA 30, which means this is going to be a .1, .2. We're using the 192.168.10.0. My gateway is the last standard, 10.254. The server will have the 10.1, and the client, we'll see what pool we'll create there, okay? And then these clients don't have any IP addresses. They'll be in this 20.0 pool, all right? And obviously, this will be in the 10, whatever. The starting IP address is what I meant, what it's going to be, okay? So we'll decide when we create the pool. But this will be in the 20 network. That'll be in the 10 network. And we'll see what happens before we configure the DHCP Relay Agent and after we configure the DHCP Relay Agent. It is important that you understand the concept that is somebody going in your behalf, grabbing the IP address from the proper pool, the correct pool of addresses, and bringing it back and allocating those IP addresses to you. Now, obviously, this is not a reality. Because let's say this is in Miami, and this is in, I don't know, Fort Lauderdale, two cities far apart from each other. Are you going to put one DHCP server to go across a wide area network so they get an IP address? No, that's not reality. It was reality at one particular school that if they were down, if headquarters was down, everybody was down. That was not good, okay? But they changed that, I think. All right, so we're going to create this. This lab is already created. We're going to configure everything from scratch. You see green lights here, but when we do it, we're going to do things from scratch. And you're going to see that we're going to use a routing protocol in order to get across. We're going to put the IP addresses on the interfaces. So understand the concepts of what's happening. They're not getting IP addresses because they're not on that DHCP server's local segment, so we need to configure a relay agent. I'm not giving the secret away. I'll give it away inside the lab. So with that said, I'll see you inside the lab. Hey, everyone. Here we are inside the DHCP Relay Agent. Like I said before, a Relay Agent is something that goes in your behalf. It's like a proxy because you don't have a DHCP server on your segment of the network. This is not reality because between two routers is really a WAN. And you're not going to be going across a WAN, even though I know some schools have done that, to get an IP address. You don't do that, okay? So that's not reality, but so you can understand the process of DHCP, which we explained it already, which is DORA, discover, offer, request, and acknowledge, right? The DORA, the discover, is broadcast. So, as you can see, I've done nothing. All I've done is just put everything out here. The PCs are going to get DHCP assigned addresses. The server itself is the 10.1. The gateway is 10.54. I have not put in anything on the routers. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to turn this DHCP into a DHCP server. Now, obviously, it's not the same way you would on a real server. Concepts, ladies and gentlemen, concepts. One of the things that you want to do here is get rid of the server pool. All right, put like 100 or something in, something like that. Save it so it doesn't interfere with what you want to do. All right, so we're going to do a new pool. We're going to go, get rid of that. We're going to do a new pool. We're going to call it the 192.168.10.0 network. Okay, and the default gateway is going to be 192.168.10.254. The DNS server address is 192.168.10.1, which is me. And then my starting IP address, so we can really know that we're actually doing something, is going to be 10.50. Oops. 50. Okay. The subnet mask is going to be a size of 24, maximum number of users. I don't care. I'm going to add it. I'm going to make sure that that's the server pool. That was the what we made our mess around with. So that's there. But I'm also going to make a pool for the 20, right? Because we have two networks here. We have the 10.0 and the 20.0. Obviously, we don't need to assign IP addresses up here, but we do to the clients on the 20 network. So we're going to add a pool for that. So we're going to change the 20, okay? The gateway is going to be 20.254, obviously. All right, and then the DNS server, we'll leave it as 10.1. He's going to be our DNS server. All right, and we're going to start at 20.50 here as well. Everything else is the same. We add it, and then we make sure. You see the 20 right there. You see the 10. So make sure the 20 gets saved. All right. So let's see how this works. First of all, we need to put some IPs. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, whether you're doing A+, Network Plus, Microsoft, basic networking, and then finally into Cisco, you better know how to IP address. If you do not know how to IP address, do not complain if the teacher is teaching you. Be happy that you're learning this, okay? I have come into certain job-related. It's like, why are you teaching me IP? Oh, because the network needs to, okay? But anyway, I'm getting off track. All right, so host name, R1. All right, interface F00. IP address 192.168.10.254, which is our gateway, 255.255.255.0. And then we turn on the interface by doing, nope, forgot a little word there, a letter, no shut, not the other one. Okay, then we go into int F0/1, and then IP address is going to be the 10.1.1.1. Is that correct? Yes, I'm using SR30. So if I'm using the 1, that means I'm using the 0 network. 255.255.255.252. Things you need to understand when you're doing this stuff. Okay? You need to understand all this stuff. All right, let's go ahead and go and do the same exact thing over here. No need, because we don't have a DHCP server on this side at all. So these are our clients. Let's see what happens. Well, we first got to configure the, the interfaces. Obviously, what am I typing? Nope. I'm going to enable. Control-Shift-6 to break out of that. Enable, config T. Host name. Just type it out, R2. All right, interface F0/1. IP address 10.1.1.2. 255.255.255.252. And if I would have gotten this wrong, I would have said, I don't think so. They would have told me just that. Now it will give me an error. Okay. Interface F0/0. IP address 192.168.20.54. 255.255.255.0. Now, for those of you asking, man, how does he know those IP addresses? Where is he getting those IP addresses from? You need to know your network. Okay, you need to know your network. You need to know if this is a SIR 30, this will be 1 and this will be 2, or this will be 1 or this will be 2. Either or, it doesn't matter. You know you're at 10.0, you have 254 IP addresses available to you. The server's got 1. Well, we're using the DHCP server. I wanted the client to get a 50. Okay, And my gateway is always the last available IP address on that particular network, which is 254, because you have 256 available, minus 2 is 254. All right, so that's where I'm getting my IP addresses. That's where I'm getting my IP addresses, okay? So let's see what, oh, wait a minute, we got one important thing. We're going across routers. This router over here has no idea that this network exists. So let's go ahead and let's make it easy. Instead of, let's go running protocol, what the heck. Let's do rip, router rip, version 2, network 10.0.0.0, oops, and network 192.168.10.0. Do not forget the no auto summary. Do not forget the no auto summary. This is for you guys taking certifications. I'm just showing you DHCP Relay Agent, but I got to get everything set up, but I wanted to show you that everything was blank and how to set things up. But just since we're here, I lost my mouse, there it is. All right, some of you are saying, hey, why is he putting the 10.0.0? Isn't it a 10.1.1.1.4.0? Well, this is the thing. It's gonna go ahead and actually summarize it. Summarize the address back to the classful boundary. That's why this is important, because this is telling it, hey, RIP, when you send out your updates, please send out the subnet mask along with it, or else it will be lost, okay? Not that it's got another 10 network to go to, but if your entire network was 10, it wouldn't know which way to go. So an auto summary is crucial. That is router 1. Let's do it for router 2. Okay, put you right here in the middle of the screen so everybody can see you. Just exit out of that. Router rip, version 2, don't forget that, because you gotta run the same versions. Network 10.0.0. Network 192.168.20.0. No auto summary. All right, tab that out. Do WR. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and verify. Do show IP route. And I'm not getting anything yet from that network over there. Is it still thinking about it or what? Going on here. Here's the 10, auto summary, version 2. Okay. Do show IP in brief. I love it. We need to, everything is up. 10.1.1.1, 10.2.4. Okay. Control Z. Oops. Show IP route. I'm getting from the 20 now. I mean, I was just too, trying to go too fast. Can't keep up with LAS. Ha 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 ha. Let me exit out of here. Let me go Control Z. Get rid of all this gibberish. Show IP route. There we go. There's the 10. Let's check for connectivity. Ping 192.168.10.254. That is the gateway of the other network, and we do have connectivity. Awesome. So let's see if this server is assigning the proper IP address. This is its own segment, so you should be able to assign it. All right. Let's take a look. And I got enough people. It's not assigning anything. That going from static to DHCP, it'll go ahead and it's like a release renew. Let's see if I even remember to turn on the DHCP server. It's off, so obviously that would not work. Okay, so we turn that on. Like I said, this is not the same thing. This is like, I guess, adding the role in your server. You try to do a DHCP server and you don't add the role and you wonder why it's not working. So let's go back here again. Let's do a release renew, and boom, there's our 10.50, there's our gateway, 10.1, all right, so let's see, 10.50, let me see if I can ping 10.50, I'm going to do an up arrow on router 2, up arrow, come on now, up arrow, it's going to do a 10.50, that is that client down there, and of course, ARP, we have to wait, boom, there it is, let me get my four bangs, and I got my four bangs, but here's the issue. These guys over here, they're not getting anything. They got an APIPA because of that discover. It's not going to get to them ever because routers do not accept. They drop broadcast traffic by default. So you need something called a relay agent, or in this case, it's called in a router, IP helper address. So we're going to a router. And we're going to go into this interface right here because this is where the packet's coming from, right? Okay, let's open this up here so you can see. And we're going to go config t, interface F0/0. And we're going to say IP helper, really? Yeah, because there's another command that's hello something. IP helper address. So what is the address of the DHCP server? 192.168.10.1. Okay, hit enter, do WR. So what that's going to do, it's going to say, okay, you are requesting, you're broadcasting out because you need an IP address. So the IP helper address is going to take that information, take that request on your behalf, turn it into a unicast, go to the server, okay? And since it already knows within the frame, all right, what is the address that you need, where it's coming from, it knows which pool to pick from. So let's go ahead and, oh, you saw that, right? It got it. There's got 1020.51 because 50 is already taken up. Well, 1051, 2051 here. And let's see this. Let's get this guy an address. And he's got the 2050. Awesome. So the IP helper address was the key to getting that. And all you had to do was go into the interface where your clients are at and type in this right here, pointing it to the DHCP server. That is it. But hey, let's verify. One of the things you're gonna do in your certification is to verify what you're doing. Okay, it's to verify what you're doing. So I'm gonna go to client. Let's see if we can go client to client. And we can go ping 192.168.20.50. Let's see. Remember, we have the ARP. Boom, there's our replies. Let's go to 51. There's our replies. Easy, easy, easy. This is part of your new DA, of your new CCNA certification. This has been around forever, all right? And they still have it there. But now you understand what it does. A relay agent, whether you're doing it on a Microsoft server or you're configuring it on the router or you're doing it on running remote access, wherever it is that you're doing it in, okay, it is somebody going on your behalf, a proxy. It's somebody going on your behalf, turning that broadcast address into a unicast, going to the DHCP server, getting the correct IP address from the proper pool because it knows where it came from. It's in the frame. And then assign you, it'll assign the proxy, it'll give the proxy, well, here you go. Take this IP address. And then it will take it and you will get your IP address allocated to you. That's all there is to it because of the process of DHCP. Remember, DORA, discover, offer, request, and acknowledge. And that DORA, that discover, is a broadcast. It will not go beyond your local segment. I hope this was helpful.